Welcome my dear students of class 10 to my history class. Today's new lesson is the Muslim League. In this lesson, some points you have to learn. What was about the attitude of the British towards the Muslims? You know, the British strongly made the Muslims responsible for the revolt of 1857. You know, the revolt of 1857, which was suppressed by the British, the role of the Muslims was very important and crucial. Both of the two communities joined hands safely, collectively, and fought against the British. And the British had to face a lot of problems in suppressing the revolt of 1857. The negative attitude of the British towards the Muslims. How was the negative attitude towards the Muslims? How was the negative attitude of the British towards the Muslims formed? It was formed only because of the negative role of the Muslims in the revolt of 1857. In the revolt of 1857, the Muslims joined hands collectively with the Hindus. The Hindus motivated the Muslims. Why? Because the last ruler of Bengal, independent Nawab of Bengal, Nawab Sirajuddullah, was defeated by the British. The British shifted the Muslims. The Muslims were the rulers of India, but the British shifted them from power. By saying it, the Hindus encouraged the Muslims to join them as a part of their protest against the British. And that the Muslims were betrayed by the British, shifted from power by the British, was true. That's why the Muslims felt it necessary to strengthen a movement, agitation, mutiny against the British so that the British could be shifted from power and a new rule could be set up in India from the part of the Indians, where both the Hindus and Muslims would rule the country instead of the British. That's why the British, in order to antagonize the British, the Muslims, you know, joined the revolt of 1857. And as a result, they formed a negative attitude of the British towards the Muslims. And the Hindus were given many facilities, but the Muslims were deprived. They were lagging behind. Another point, educational and economic backwardness of the Muslims. Educational and economic backwardness of the Muslims. You know, the Muslims from the very, very beginning refused to accept the Western education, the knowledge of English, because they did not accept it to be ignored. The two languages, Persian and Farsi, as official languages. They favored these two languages as official languages, but the British shifted these two languages, and instead of these two languages, they made an arrangement that only of one official language would be there, that was English language. And besides, some mother tongues of different states of India could be used. But the British did not give importance to the sentiments of the Muslims. As a result, the Muslims felt insulted and decided to non-cooperate with the British from time to time, so that the British must come to know about the aggressiveness of the Muslims. That the Muslims were arrogant and aggressive in their nature and habit, the British knew it. The British knew it from the very beginning. That's why, in order to create a sense of responsibilities like the Hindus, they decided to give many advantages to the Hindus, so that the Muslims must come forward to take the advantages from the Britishers. But they were arrogant. Ultimately, the Hindus took its advantages. The Hindu middle class people received Western education, and on being educated through Western system, on being educated through the language English, they were given many responsible posts in the administration under the British. And financially, economically, Hindu middle class people became more and more self-sufficient, but the Muslims, they were lagging behind. So it was another reason the Britishers tried to make a division between these two communities, but the Muslims did not give them such an opportunity to do it. So next one, rise of aggressive nationalism. Rise of aggressive nationalism. You know, the Muslims and the Hindus, both the two sipais, the Hindus and the Muslims, fought collectively, jointly, during the revolt of 1857 against the British. They had always been very, very closely bonded together, but the national movement was dominated by the upper class Western, educated Hindus, absence of any major community leaders also weakened the opposition in the national movement. And as a result, the Muslim aspirations were being, ignored. The Muslims' aspirations were being ignored. The assertive nationalists in the national movement spoke about their motherland and referred to nationalism as their religion. It discouraged the Muslims. The Muslims felt that they were not minor class people. That's why they were given an importance. The kind of imaginary was not much in sync with their religious beliefs, alienating the Muslims even further. The nationalists stressed on great Hindus, the Hindu kings of Indian history, as their icons, ignoring some of the remarkable cultural and intellectual progress made by the Muslims during medieval period. The Muslims felt insulted for that, because some important Muslim leaders during medieval period, they improved a lot, but they made the all-round development throughout the country, but the Hindus declined it, the Hindus ignored their role. It touched the sentiments of the Muslims. Now, finally, next point, the British divide and rule. The British decided to make a division between these two communities, but they had been eagerly waiting for that opportunity. How they could avail it, and that great opportunity came. It is generally perceived that the British had always followed a policy of divide and rule from the very, very beginning. But at the time when the last Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar was killed along with his two sons, both of them, along Bahadur Shah Zafar was not paid honor and dignity. But that's why ultimately Bahadur Shah Zafar died of starvation, due to the body, the refired, the body weak due to his weakness. The British did not take care of his health and of his body. There was no proper treatment of Bahadur Shah Zafar. That's why, while staying there at Rangoon as war prisoner, Bahadur Shah Zafar died broken heart. And in front of him, his two sons also were killed. So the Muslim people did not forget it, did not forget that very insult. The last Mughal emperor, Bahadur Shah Zafar, had to digest. That's why the Muslim people did not cooperate with the British, in spite of being taken several attempts to make a division between the two communities, so that the unity between the Hindus and Muslims must be weakened. Ultimately, the British began to feel that encouraging the Muslims would help in creating momentum. The British began to feel encouraging the Muslims would be would help in creating communal tension. So ultimately, they encouraged the Muslims by telling them about the negative side of the Hindus, that the Hindu leaders were denouncing the Muslim rulers who once upon a time ruled this country, India. And on the other hand, they also encouraged the Hindu leaders against the Muslims, that the Muslims did not like the Hindus. The Muslims demanded their separatist, the Muslims demanded their separate political party. Their own aggressive nationalism among them, although they were minority people, yet they demanded their crucial role in Indian politics. That's why they denounced, they criticized the policies of the Hindus. So the British intentionally, deliberately started making a division between the two communities by criticizing against each other. But the Muslims finally was trapped by the Britishers and decided to reduce their aggressiveness and aggressive attitude towards the Muslims. They decided to stop their aggressive attitude towards the British, and they also decided to receive Western education in the interest of their community, so that they must receive Western education and must be appointed in the British administration and must earn a sufficient income, must earn a lot of money, and must become self-sufficient financially, socially, and politically. So in order to do it, the Muslims favored the British and their policy and started criticizing the policies of the Hindus. And ultimately, what happened? They began to feel that if the national movement was successful under the Hindus, their plight would be even worse under the Hindu dominion. That's why they must have to make separate arrangement for themselves, so that in future they must produce their demand separately before the British, and the British must accept it, and the community must be benefited with that system. They should not depend on the Hindus and their political leaders. They should not become a part of the, you know, Indian national movement. That's why the separatist tendency, which was supposed to be created among them by the British became successful in making it so. Up to this, my dear students, thank you. Next day, the remaining part. And all of you, once again, I am telling you, all of you, my best wishes for you for performing well in the last exam you have done. Thank you. You have done successfully.